like so sad when Grandpa died in chapter 19. Same. It was sad, like how it all happened too.
I didn't really understand though how he died.
Well, like yeah, because they shot the gun and then like something happened and then did the bullet hit him?
No.
No. Okay. Good. Cause like I was really confused on that part because it was like it shot and then it bounced off him.
Like he's been coughing and he got like really red face and then like the guy was choking him so he couldn't breathe and then he just he laid down and then he just died there.
He's been coughing
through the whole book.
So grandfather was had the gun, he shot it, just missed him. The guy grabbed his neck, hit his head against the wall, they left and then he died.
Really surprising that like Maddie actually got the sword and actually hit the guy.
The guy did not think she would do it at all, but she did it.
Yeah, because when you love somebody, I mean, you don't really think about what you do. You just do it.
You don't think twice.
And then, like, right after, you're like, did that. It was worth it, but, like, I literally just did that.
I know, because, like, you don't think twice about it. You just full on do it. It's like, who cares? Like, you're trying to protect someone that you love. Like,
Has everybody had a loss here?
Yeah.
You know how it feels like when you lose somebody, it feels like you're gonna die, and like a chunk of your heart is like
it just like
out.
It feels like you're just like helpless, like
sand. It's like quicksand. You're just drowning.
It's like
But like you can't even, since she hasn't found her mother yet. Like you can't even think about your mom dying. I think she thinks that she's dead or something, and she's just like she just can't,
because like her whole world is like mixed up now.
Another sad part was like on page 129 in chapter 17. They were like thanking each other for like keeping each other alive. They were like, "Thank you, Father, for keeping me alive. Please punish the people who wrecked our home and stole our food." And then he was like, "No, that's not right." And then they were probably just hungry and they needed some food, and then she was like, "Please just punish them at least a little bit."
I was really scared when that guy started slapping Matilda.
I thought she was gonna die.
I'm like, oh my god, like what could happen? Because like
she's
14.
She's like only a 14-year-old girl, and then a grown man slapping her.
Grandpa comes out with his like shaking crazily.
I know.
He just woke up too.
He was like 1, 2, and then 3, and then he shot.
And then Matilda's like, my grandpa never jokes around when he counts to 3. One time, like I did this, and he did this to me.
And then he beat her. He
whipped her.
That was the only time he ever hurt her, and that he ever got to 3 for her.
Also, end of chapter 19, it said, the first year, praying in the morning, I passed the night kneeling by the side of the finest man I have ever known. That was like, oh my god.
It was so dramatic.
I wonder if the mom is going to come back or if she's dead.
Like, yeah. No. I wonder what will happen to Matilda.
Dramatic. They're stealing things from her. They shot guns. They were slapping. Like that was intense.
Or when Grandpa died, like it was really weird. Like everybody was like, "I'm not gonna pray for your grandpa." But the one guy that was pushing the wheelbarrow was like, "Yeah, I understand what you're talking about. We need to pray for him." And then she just stood up and started praying, and everybody like took off their hats.
Yeah,
it was like really peaceful.
Even
though like nobody was gonna do anything, she had to do it all
herself.
She
was yelling at them.
She was so mad.
If that happened to me, I would have done the same.
Because back to the point, like, if you love somebody, you have to do something. You don't even think. She pushed a guy down that was, like, a full man. And, like, pushed him down to the ground, almost fell in the hole. And he's like, she's like, "We need to pray. Like, where's the pastor?" Like, she didn't even think. And then the guy pushing the barrel understood her. So I think he had something like that in his life. And he's like, "Yes, you need to." For the Bible, and they all like, Nina said, they all like took off their hats and were like, "This is the right thing to do."
Respecting it.
Peaceful.
I don't know if this is like apart from like before, but when they're riding home from Bush Hill and they confused. Like, is he, like, stuck in a mattress, or is he on top of a mattress?
I think it was, like, because he had the fever, like, he was just stuck, and he didn't want to move because it would hurt to move. He's laying on the mattress, like, all, like, stuck because he was scared.
So he wasn't, like, inside the mattress.
Look, I didn't think he was inside
the mattress. No. It was, like, the mattress and the guy are all matched up together on the floor.
I think it was, you know how they, when they're sick, you don't want to touch the person that's sick.
Well, yeah.
So they probably carried the bed out, put him on the
floor. Yes, because he didn't want to move, so.
So they could, he couldn't. And they didn't want to lift him.
Because he didn't want to get the fever.
Also, another thing that was, like, really heartbreaking was when that, Matilda picked up the doll. She's like, is this your doll? And, like, the girl's like, yeah. And she's like, it's broken. And she asked where her parents were, and they're like,
she's like, mom's broken too.
Yeah, I know. That was so
that just
sad.
Got me. That just, like,
it hit like, you. It's like, oh my god.
It's, I mean, you can see it on the top, like, okay, her mom's dead. But then if you go deeper, it's like, oh my gosh. Just the symbolism and between the doll and the mom.
And that just hurts you. It's just like, oh my god.
Yeah. Also, going back to when Grandpa died, Matilda really made us, well, me feel like I was hurt. Like, what she was experiencing.
Yeah.
She was like, goodbye.
The author did that really well.
Yeah. Explained it.
That was, like, just amazing. Like, it was really sad, and it really caught you, and it was, like, pulling you down. And it was, like,
it's just, like, you made
it's just, like, you lost somebody, like, just then.
The author, like, made you feel her emotions,
what was
like, in that.
Big fact question.
I want to know what she's going to do with the little girl. Like, is she going to keep her? Is she going to take her to the orphan house?
Yeah, Avery, what do you think? My fat question is, like I said before, what will happen to Matilda? Will she, like, survive, or will she, like, just, like, die?
Like, is she going to get the fever again?
You can't get the fever again.
No, once you have it, and then you cure it.
They kept saying that, like, once you get the fever, it won't come down.
Like, but if you did.
That's like when you get the fever. That's why everybody was like, once you had the fever, if you recovered it, like everybody wanted to help you because they couldn't get it again.
They wanted Maddie in like all the fever hospitals.
Cause she already had it and then she couldn't get it again.
So I don't know. I think this is in chapter 21, but I also think it's in 20. So I'm not sure. But you know when that guy like separated from his friends that was really filthy and stuff, and he just tried to pluck Nell off of her.
I know.
Like,
and then she bit her.
Yeah, I was like, oh my gosh, that's awesome. Like, go now. But that's also disgusting.
I know. I know. Ew. His hands are probably like disgusting, dirty. It's
who
like,
knows where they've been.
At this point, who knows where he's been?
Like,
he could have been at a fever hospital.
Yeah.
Or something.
And like, she just had to run, and like, she found the strength in her legs, but then right when she got in the back alley, she was like,
I
know,
that
would have been like, that
was
your
dream.
Love, come dance with me.
Yeah, no.
Bye.
And like, I think I hear somebody calling my name. Bye.
It's like, bye, no,
Matilda, there's my call.
Yeah.
Matilda, there it is again. I'd be like, running.
Was anyone like, confused in any other parts than we discussed about?
And I have to go check.
Also, that old lady, like, when she was looking in the house, she was, like, gonna be like,
I need a camera right here.
Yeah. That's my description of her.
Okay, anyway.
Like, she was just so mean to Matilda. She's like, I'm looking for friends, and she's like just yelling and like being so mean, and like that's not even her house.
Who knows if that was her house?
Huh?
Yeah.
Come on.
She could have stole that house, bro.
No,
nobody really knows.
Confused about the I don't know where this was, but the hot yellow hot air balloon, the red yellow stuff hanging off the house.
Oh, the yellow tags that like
that means
marked that it was fever.
If you think about it, the yellow tags would represent the yellow fever.
Because it's yellow. It's like,
you're supposed to get
I probably should have, like, caught on to that.
Like, that should have just clicked into it.
Because, like, if they get too attached, if she gets too attached, and then it's going to be way too hard to put her in the orphan house. But she could also take care of her.
I have no idea. Well, she really can't take care of her.
Okay, can I go to chapter 21, please?
Go ahead. Okay. You're dying.
Yes. Since they found Eliza, finally, like, out of, like, 20 chapters.
Like, where have you been?
I was like, oh my goodness, thank you. That's why she was running after. And, I hope that Eliza and her will be able to take care of Mel, because I think Mel, really likes Maddie, and Maddie really likes her back. I hope, they get to stay together.
So I was like, but she, Matilda, she found Eliza, but what if Eliza can't care for Matilda, and Matilda can't really care for herself yet because she's too young?
Yeah.
Then she can't care for Nell either.
Yeah. Oh, and since Eliza, Eliza's brother has a fever or something like that. I forgot. He's just sick or something. I wonder if they have enough food for everybody.
Bless you.
Bless you.
Thank you.
Enough food for anybody and water and things like that.
Yes. Bless you. Thank you.
Is Joseph her husband or her brother?
Brother.
And then is the two twins.
Twins. Yeah.
Her kids.
Oh,
are they her
you
kids?
Don't even know what they look like. Okay.
Are they her kids? Are they her kids?
Are they her kids? I think they're Joseph's kids.
No,
she's their aunt.
That makes so much more sense. Since the twins' mom died, what if the dad dies?
Yeah.
Then Eliza will have to take care of four kids.
Oh gosh.
But then honestly,
four.
Mel,
Maddie,
the boys.
Babies. But Matilda could help out.
What if they couldn't find enough food or shelter?
Yeah. Okay, so there's more to talk about.
And I think
we kind of went over everything.
I predict
nothing, because then you would spoil the book.
Thank you, Avery, for getting me out of that.
I think that we should start reading the next chapter.
Yeah.